just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Craddock has the ball teed up, and we're just about ready to get this one started. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. He unloads it. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
Hey, I know he dropped it, but the safety put himself in a position to make a play. That's impressive.
That makes it second and 10.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. There's a strike complete. The 50, and they finally push him out at the 46-yard line.
This is a great pitch and catch combination, and they hook up here for a big-time game.
They'll bring him down right around the 38-yard line.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That makes it second and 2.
He's taken down right around the 30. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it second and 4.
And down he goes at the 23.
Call it a gain of 1 yard. That'll bring up 3rd and 4.
Here he goes. The 10. Touchdown, Marshall. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
Big time play, taking that ball all the way in. Maybe the defense wasn't expecting a run.
And he tacks on the extra point. A nice 7-play, 76-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. So our score, 7-0. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Diggs fields it at the 3. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. Maryland's offense, a lot of times they can spread things out and they can really be versatile offensively. But when you got a wide receiver like this, it really helps the cause.
Well, it does, and it continues to help with what they're trying to do. They're trying to find matchups. And when you have one player like this that the defense has got to be aware of, they're going to spread you out, try to find the one-on-one matchup. And if you spend too much time with this one player, they've got some other weapons to make you pay for it.
Quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Jacobson's the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up
from their own 28-yard line. It's 3rd down. Now he tries to buy some time. They bring him down.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
And that's 3 and out. Nothing going on that series. Smith is the deep man awaiting the return. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line.
Return for a gain of 9 yards.
Pretty good looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there. Marshall is up a score. Tackle made
at about the 39-yard line.
Good solid running right there. Getting past the defensive lineman and into the secondary before he could be stopped.
And he just gets rid of it. From the 39-yard line, it's second down.
Tackle around the 40-yard line.
Massive run on the play. Makes it third and 11.
He's under pressure. He wants it all. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
And they make the stop right around the 6-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That brings up second and goal.
The middle for a nice run.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. That makes it third and goal.
Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Number 5, the intended receiver on the play.
So from a yard out, the offense is going to try to stay on the field here on fourth down and goal. Marshall is up 7. Touchdown, Thundering Herd.
This kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
And he adds the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick.
Lost sets a return.
Taken from the 3-yard line. And down he goes at the 21-yard line.
Not a lot of success for this offense on their last trip out.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
Brought down at the 29.
The defense snuffed out the option play pretty well there.
Yeah, but they didn't do it quickly enough. The quarterback decided to keep this one himself, and the hole was just big enough that he was able to get the first down.
The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call.
False start, offense.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
So we'll have first and 15 after the penalty. The middle for a nice game. Brown gains about 5 yards on the run.
Well, player down, and his teammates obviously worried after that play.
Looking right, intercepted.
Well, that's exactly what this defensive coordinator wanted to see. Somebody come up with a big play. Right when it looked like this team might be able to get back in the game, they come up with the big interception and maintain the momentum here in the first half.
From the 32-yard line, it's first down. So the officials are going to take a look at some of the replay angles.
And what they're looking for is whether or not the ball touched the ground before he had possession.
Yeah.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
The ruling on the field stands. It's a catch. Throws incomplete.
Number five was the intended receiver on the play.
Second and ten. Ball on the 32. He's tackled at about the 33-yard line. Throws a bullet. Nice catch on that one. Touchdown! Big play! Kirk, that was a beautiful pass and a nice catch.
Well, this is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly, and again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. The Terrapins saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll take it from the two. At the 30, and he's taken down at the 32-yard line.
Marshall's got people flying all over the field on defense right now.
Boy, they sure do. Right now, we're just seeing great defensive effort. They have a plan. They understand it. They're playing with great speed, and they're not giving up big plays. That's why they're playing well up to this point.
Offense comes back out, looking to improve from their last effort.
He's got a lot of time to forget about that last pick. He's just got to stick to the game plan.
And they got him.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. Let's it fly.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Wants to throw outside, and that one's incomplete. So they couldn't pick up the long yardage, and now they'll have to punt.
On third down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt. Tackle made at the 42-yard line.
Marshall's taking no prisoners in this game so far, Herbie.
Well, they've really exploited some one-on-one opportunities and came up with some big plays that eventually have led to those touchdowns.
And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it two touchdowns in two possessions.
And it was a really nice drive, too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
Carries the ball. That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
First quarter's over. Watch out, folks. This one is turning into a major upset. 21 to nothing. Thundering Herd. Back to the action now here in the second quarter.
27 mark. 226.
Quick pass. Oh, so close to breaking it.
Well, they found some seams in the coverage there. Let's see if the defense makes any adjustments to counter.
Run there as they work the outside.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. And he's taken down around the 5-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Come on, come on.
They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
Loss of 2 yards on the play. That brings up second and goal.
They're at the 7. It's second down. Pass out to the tight end, but it's incomplete.
The pass was right on target, so that took a perfectly timed hard hit to knock it free. Strong defense to deny the completion.
He's on the run. There's a missed tackle. Touchdown, Marshall! He made a great move to get into the end zone.
There's a perfect play call. They look like they practiced that one a few times.
He makes the PAT. Marshall gets set to kick this one away. Fielded at the 4. He gets out to about the 28-yard line.
No matter how much people want to talk about points and offense, I still think that the best offense is a great defense. When you put a 0 up there, it makes it pretty easy on your own offense to go out there and win the game.
I'm really surprised how lopsided this first half has been. But this is college football, and no matter what the score is, the adrenaline's always pumping on both sides. Second down and 16. Ball on the 23-yard line. Gets it. He's in space. They'll bring him down around the 32-yard line. He's scrambling. And he's level at the 46.
Gain of 14 yards. That makes it first and 10.
He steps out at the 43. Here's the throw to the fullback.
6 yards on the play. That brings up second and 13.
From their own 43-yard line, second down. Looking to scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure.
Third down.
Throw, incomplete pass. The quarterback had a tough time with a blitz on that one.
With this guy, you can't let him stand back there and have too much time to throw the ball. You've got to get a hand in his face.
Renfro awaits the snap. Smith fields it at the 22. He makes it to the 32-yard line. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Marshall, up big. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 8.
And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's a gain of 7 on the play. first down.
Got his man. Oh, what a hit.
Gain of 4 yards. That brings up second and five.
And down he goes, right around the 40.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. First down.
He gets rid of this one.
From the 40-yard line, second down.
And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line.
That'll bring up third and six. First and 10.
Marshall comes to the line holding that commanding lead. Pass complete and taken down immediately. Shuler gained 7 yards with a catch there. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. They get nice yardage on that run. Marshall's going to have to use their second time out of the half. It's the 11th play of the drive. Nice run up the middle.
Gain 7 on the play. That brings up second and goal.
Touchdown, Thundering Herd.
Wow. Complete dominance so far on both sides of the football. For one side, I have a feeling this game is going to feel a lot longer than 60 minutes.
And he converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. Across the 30. He's taken down at the 33. Maryland's offense is so predicated on what this wide receiver does. And now when you consider that we've got a couple of quarters left, they've got to change the complexion of the game a little bit. They're going to have to do it with somebody else, I think.
This is really where a coaching staff gets challenged, because for 5 or 6 days you prep and you look at a lot of film and you kind of come into a game by the time Saturday rolls around and you have a good idea of how you want to attack the defense. And then you go out there and it's not working. You have to show an ability as a coaching staff to go back and look at that drawing board and eliminate some things and maybe add some things and be able to try to make the adjustments you need to give your team a chance to win in the second half.
Fires out quickly to the tailback. He's taken down
at about the 37-yard line.
Quickly to the tight end. Steps out of bounds at the 42.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. That'll make it fourth and 2.
Renfro is the punter. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. Marshall's done what they had to do offensively. They've done a nice job here in the first half, partner.
Boy, it's been very consistent for them, and consequently, they have a nice lead here going into halftime. But again, they've got to be able to do a nice job here of continuing to fight, because this offense that they're facing across the line of scrimmage on the other side of the ball, they can score in a hurry, so there's still a lot of football to be played.
He airs it out. That last catch gives him 100 yards receiving.
Now, if you were to ask this defense, who wants to cover this guy, I bet you nobody's going to raise their hand, because this receiver is embarrassing them.
And we're still in the first half, so there's a lot of time left for this kid to build on those statistics. He lets it fly. Oh, boy, almost intercepted.
Boy, this is a great play by the safety to be able to be in a position to make this play, but he's got to be able to hold on to the football. You know, he's a big, physical, athletic guy. You've got to be able to secure a football and make a big play when it presents itself.
And he can't get away from the pressure. Marshall in control. Nice grab on the play. We've still got a half of football remaining. Marshall's running away with it.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. I really hope you'll stick around and watch the second half of this game. During the second half, I expect Kirk Herbstreit to give us a comprehensive history of every playbook he's ever had in his entire football career dating back to Pee Wee. That would be infinitely more interesting than having to watch the second half of this blowout.
Definitely, that would be probably more entertaining. We get on games all the time. They start to get out of hand. You got to empty the bucket. So, guys, back to you. Have some fun. Tell me something I don't know. These teams are pretty boring.
Give me something from the human interest file, Brad Nessler. Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You're looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here. Got a good, good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later. We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Is it stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
Very lopsided first two quarters. We'll hope for better as we head into the third. It's fielded at the two. They'll bring him down at the 31.
Marshall's coaching staff will go out tonight. I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. He's going to try and scramble. Tries to get around the corner. He keeps it. Slides down. Here's the halfback on the screen. Brought down at about the 29-yard line. It in and he's in the open field. He gets hit out of bounds at about the 23-yard line.
That'll make it second and four.
Complete. What a catch. Big play, and it's first and goal. They make the stop at the two.
No gain. That brings up second and goal.
Second down and goal. 2 yards to the end zone. Tackle around the 4-yard line.
Loss of two on the play.
And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Yeah, let's go set lunch.
Hey, check my
Ready! Touchdown, Maryland!
That's what makes this offense so tough to defend. When you have a quarterback with the ability to run and throw, and he gets down into this area of the field, chances are he's going to find his way into the end zone.
And he adds the extra point. Braddock, ready to kick. excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
So they're just about set to get the game going again.
Marshall looking to build on his commanding lead here. Up the middle for a nice game.
Gain of four on the play. That makes it second and six.
He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he's shoved out of bounds at about the 35.
It's a gain of five on the play. Right. First down.
In the middle. He's tackled around the 48-yard line.
Whitfield makes the tackle at the 48-yard line. First down.
Makes the catch and look out. And he's tackled at the 44-yard line.
That's a gain of eight on the play. That makes it second and two.
Let's go, let's go. Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
Got an opening. And he hits him hard at the 33-yard line.
Gain of 11 yards. That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 33-yard line. Watson takes the delayed handoff. He fights forward to about the 33.
That makes it second and 10.
Tackle made at the 34. Marshall up by a bunch. He's looking for six. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
Smith, the intended receiver on the play.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down.
Two down. Let's go, let's go.
Quick toss. Caught sideline and he stays in.
Here's a great example of what this man is capable of. As receivers go, he's as electric as they come.
They'll get him in the backfield.
That's a 4-yard line. That brings up second and goal.
It's second and goal. 7 yards for the touchdown. And he's taken down at the 4-yard line.
Called a gain of 3 yards. That makes it third and goal.
They run it, and they got him before he can score.
That was a loss of 1 yard. That brings up fourth and goal.
It's fourth down. They're going to go for the easy three here. This will just add insult to injury. He gets it up, and it splits the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Not a whole lot's been working for them so far. They should just come out and play loose and easy because they've got nothing to lose. He throws right.
Down.
he tries to buy some time. Slides down to the ground. He's on the run. Room around the corner. He's knocked out of bounds at the 29. They'll bring him down around the 23-yard line. Rifles it. Got his receiver. Touchdown.
White out here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
Boy, just a great play here, Brad, by the wide receiver. And I really think the quarterback did a good job of putting the football where only his receiver could make a play on it, and he had the hands there to haul it in for the touchdown.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Braddock looks ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Terrapins have simply rocked the college football world with an astounding effort in this one.
This is one of the biggest upsets I think we've seen all year. You know what's great? They didn't worry about any of the outside distractions. They just kind of locked in to themselves and their coaches, getting ready for this football game, and it's really paid off for them.
Throws complete, and he's hit right away. Fourth quarter is here, and it's starting to look more and more like an upset is imminent. 38-14, Marshall. Second and four. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Get him for a loss.
Nothing doing that time. Defender stayed home. The blocking wasn't there, and down he went.
It's third down and five to go. Ball on the 30-yard line. And he's hit immediately. They pick up a few yards there on the pass.
And I'll tell you what, that fake handoff froze the secondary just enough to allow for the receiver to come up with a nice gain that time. Good call.
Throws it in a hurry. Out of bounds at the 44. He's hit the 300-yard mark with that throw.
Well, this quarterback has had a solid game. He's done what's been asked of him and then some.
You can see when he throws the ball well, this team usually wins. It's first and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. A great tackle at the 45. 1 yard loss for the halfback.
I'm sure this running back will be looking around for that guy the next time he takes a handoff.
Here we go. Deep all day. Defense all day. All day. 47 right.
And down he goes. Right around the 46-yard line.
The defense was able to get really good penetration and drop him short of the line of scrimmage.
From the 46-yard line, third down. Gets it out. He's met immediately. Great punt blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. And this one is a beauty. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around.
Check, 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 check.
their own 20-yard line. It's second down. Fires it out. He's taken down at the 31-yard line.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
He's scrambling. Runs with it, and he's got room. Brought down at the 43. Scrambling. Decides to slide. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Scrambling around. He's at the 30. Good open field tackle.
A good quarterback knows when and how to improvise. And if he's got the skills, he can also turn a scramble into something big.
First and 10. Ball on the 27. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. Pass right, running back's got it. And they make the stop at the 21.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete.
Well, he must have hurried there because his receiver was wide open. There was no need to rush that one at all.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. His halfback, first down. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
That makes it 1st and 4.
Tackle right around the 2-yard line. Throws it and is caught for the touchdown. He stepped up and threw a touchdown pass to his wideout.
Yep, good job of protection, and the quarterback spotted his man.
And they're looking to get 2 points here. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. So with less than 2 to go in the fourth quarter, the score is Marshall 38, Maryland 22. He's tackled at the 42-yard line. And what a game it's been for this quarterback, Kirk.
Well, it's been a fun afternoon because he's having a lot of success. And the reason is he's in tune with his receivers and they're really playing with a great rhythm. The thing that surprised me today is that we know about his ability to throw the football, but here's a guy that can also hurt you with his feet if he has to.
Well, with a 2-possession lead, this one's all but over. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He fights forward to about the 39. Maryland's going to take their first time out of the half. 2nd and 7. Ball on the 39. Run play and he'll lose yards. The Terrapins use their 2nd timeout. Makes it out to about the 29. Maryland will take their last time out. He's at the 20. And And that sets them up with a first and goal.
That's good for a gain of 20 yards. That makes it first and goal.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. They'll knock him down for a loss. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. Favorite play in football if you're a quarterback. Take a knee. Diggs' impact on today's game, Kirk. We are expecting it to be on the positive side. Unfortunately for them, it ended up being a negative.
Yeah, definitely a tough loss to swallow. Typically, you'd like to see some other players step up and kind of help the cause when your great star player doesn't have an outstanding game. But in this case, I don't know if it would have made much of a difference.
Well, that wraps things up for us. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.